Hey there everyone, a very warm welcome to each and every one of you at my channel Align and Attract. My name is Neha Bhatia, and if you would like to learn to manifest a bit faster, this video is for you. So many of us want to manifest something in our life, either that's relationship, that's money, that's something to do with our personal growth, but we are not able to manifest it faster. Of course, we have a lot of blockages around, but then the process needs to be correct and it should be accurate. So what all we are missing, we need to fill that up and you will start to see manifestation really fast. All right, so first thing first, it's very important to understand how do we visualize. So how are we visualizing? Please understand that. We are visualizing through our eyes, right? We visualize here. The moment we close our eyes, we are seeing something here. We are actually seeing it here on our mental screen, and this is the Ajna Chakra, right? This is called the third eye, right? So what all is stored over here? This is the mind, right? The brain. So all the thoughts are usually here. That's why there are a lot of people who feel anxiety and they have a lot going in their life. They feel very heavy here. So you need to clear space here so that now you can enter something, right? You can put something here, which is your own goal or whatever you want to visualize. So how to clear off this space? If, for example, you have a 2 BHK house, okay, and in one room you stay, in the other room there is a tenant. So if you want to have another tenant, you need to let go of this current tenant, right? So these thoughts are our tenant, and these negative thoughts, or could be any thoughts, this space needs to be absolutely empty so that the mind is absolutely clear that this is what I want, okay? There is no interferences. Okay, so how do you clear that? So we also made a video on that. It's called tapping. So you basically tap on these areas, especially the center of the eyebrows, and then this, and also here. Tap a couple of times, let's say 11 times here, 11 times here, and then 11 times here, and then you come back and go a little slow, so it becomes a little more meditative and you go into relaxed deep state, and then you put on your visualization or affirmation. That's the time it works even faster. Another way to do it is that you use breath work. So when you do breath work, either that is any kind of pranayama or whatever you're doing, deep breathing, it helps you. But I'll tell you what I do and you can try that as well. So if it's morning, then I prefer doing any visualization. If I'm doing, I prefer doing Kapalbhati before I do any visualization. So I'll tell you something very interesting about Kapalbhati. In Kapalbhati, there will be a moment after the rounds, right, wherein you are not breathing in and you're not breathing out. There is no exhalation or inhalation happening. Do you know about it? It happens after Kapalbhati for 4 to 5 seconds or 3 to 4 seconds it will happen, and that is a moment when you actually sit down and listen to the affirmation, because at that time you're in very, very deep state, okay? But you of course do it after you complete the rounds. You have really raised your energy, because Kapalbhati helps you a lot in raising your energy instantly. It is really good for your solar plexus chakra, and it's amazing for increasing your confidence and just boosting you up completely. So once you are completely ready in high vibe and then you do the affirmation or the visualization, it works even faster. What I do in the night, if I do a visualization of a couple of days, I'm doing a visualization or affirmation, or we also design scripts for our people, and I design it for myself as well. Scripts as in your life script. So if you would like to design one, you can always take up a private session with me, wherein I work on patterns and we help you design your life script. So I do that a lot with my clients and with myself as well. So that is something I prefer to do it in the night. So let's say if I'm about to go to bed, I will do alternate nostril breathing. I hope you know about that. If not, then I'll put the link in the description box. Please do have a look at it. Once we do alternate nostril breathing, again, it's breath work. Breath is something that can bring you in the present moment, right? And it can, of course, make you feel very relaxed. And if it's the night time, you feel more relaxed and you want to go to bed, right? So what is happening in the alternate nostril breathing, that number one, that, you know, your energy centers, your energy is being aligned, you're becoming more relaxed, and then you go to bed and then you're almost in that sleep state. So when you're almost in that sleep state, our subconscious mind works even faster. So when you're in deep sleep, at that time, if you listen something or see something, it becomes even faster. Okay? So another way of getting your manifestation faster is that you don't just focus on achieving. If you just focus on achieving that one goal, oh, I want this car, I want that house. So it will come, but it will give you a bit of anxiety and restlessness and a bit of possessiveness towards your goal, and that is the whole idea. You don't have to become possessive. You have to let it go completely, and that is something most of us don't know. We don't know how to surrender it to the universe, how to surrender it to the higher self. We just keep holding on to it by becoming so possessive of that one goal. No, it's about, you know, in Bhagavad Gita also we have learned, it's about doing. So there are many laws in this world. One is law of attraction, but then there is a law of karma as well. And law of karma says that do. You know, do what is required, not just want all the time. Because when we are wanting all the time, we become very attached to it. It brings us a lot of misery and suffering, right? So you definitely put that in your mind. And I have seen the movie Secret more than 50 times, more than 50 to 70 times in the last 10 years. And that's why I was able to visualize and I was able to attract such good work and money and good relationships in my life. But yes, there were times when there was a bit of misery as well because I was getting a bit attached. So here it's important to understand that there is something called as law of karma, wherein you do what is required, not just focus. So when you're visualizing, see in your visualization that you're doing all these things. Also start to visualize what you're doing for other people, how the other people are happy when they are being benefited with your manifestation or with your achievements, right? So that is another thing that's very, very important for you to understand while you're in the process of manifestation. Another thing that is extremely important, which probably you might not know of, as an NLP trainer, we help people with the hypnotic language. So I teach that in the Train the Trainer workshop, or if somebody comes to me and take up a private session, then I customize it. So it's very important for whatever language you're using while you're visualizing or doing affirmation, it's very important that you use the hypnotic language. Hypnotic language does wonders. So there is a way to do it, and it's supposed to be done just sitting with a mentor or under guidance. So once you sit with me and you understand it, your manifestation will become really faster. Okay, and the last thing, and I would also like to give you a challenge on that. You know, there are a lot of times when we are running after something, let's say we want something, we want to manifest something. It could be just a good relationship, okay? It could also be doing something for the society. But a lot of times we tend to procrastinate, we tend to get affected by the environment. So here's a challenge that I used to take back in days, and I used to take it in a little wrong way, but now I do it correctly, just evolving, growing and learning. The challenge is that you need to leave something to get this one thing in your life. What is the challenge? That you leave something. So I used to do back in days, I used to leave eating, I used to stop eating food for 2-3 days. Although that's not good, because all of a sudden if you stop eating food, it's not good for your system. But, it also gives you that sudden boost in the energy. And manifestation is all about the energy game, right? So it's not about food, but just leave something or drop something which is like a pleasure for you, which gives you a lot of happiness. You don't have to leave, you don't have to leave eating food or something which can give you a lot of pain, but something that will give you a little bit of pain and have an awareness that, you know what, if I leave this and if I can get my task done, then naturally I'm going to enjoy this even more. For example, there are people who loves to go on good shopping, right? And they'll just burn off their money on the credit card. So maybe you can take up a task or you can take up a challenge that I'm not gonna buy or I'm not gonna shop for at least 10 days till the time these tasks are done. So I'm not talking about goal, till the time I achieve this goal, no. Till the time I do these 3 tasks which will get me the goal, which will help me manifest, till the time these tasks are not done, I will not go and shop and blow off my money with a credit card. So please understand this, that what is happening is that you are actually associating a bit of pain as well. that you want. This is like a pleasure for you, and that's like a pain for you, because if you're going to leave that, it's going to give you a little bit of pain. So what will happen is that all your energy will go into this. And now after 10 days, you would want to go and blow off your money, and probably you will end up blowing a little more. So that's where the balance comes into the picture. That's why I'm making you aware. So that's the time when you need to know that, okay, what is more important for me, right? And trust me, all these excitement and cravings and attachments and addictions that we have of food, of shopping, it is just some other need that is not being fulfilled. So once we achieve that particular goal, that need will get fulfilled, and slowly and gradually, you will be able to save a lot on your credit card. I'm not joking, it works. So this is a way that you can use in your own life and make your manifestation a little bit faster. And if you're interested, how about you write it in the comment box that yes, I'm interested. And let me just send out a good energy to you here, a good ball of energy, and let's manifest together. Thank you so much. Please make sure that you do subscribe to my channel and check out nlpvidneha.com, wherein we have all our courses. We have courses on communication, NLP, money mapping, and many more going on. So I would love to have you on this journey with us. Thank you so much. See you in the next video.